Zoot. Copland's patriotic band here was composed in 1942 for the Cincinnati Symphony Orchestra, one of 18 fanfares written to promote patriotic response at America's entry into the Second World War, and the only one still performed regularly. The name of the piece was inspired in part by a speech given by U.S. Vice President Henry Wallace. We are so excited to be making our debut at the Evansville Wartime Museum. I'd like to take this time to thank the staff for inviting us. They're a wonderful staff and they are a gem in our community. Let's give it up for the staff of the Wartime Museum. Evansville's contribution to World War II is well documented, and we are going to highlight these contributions throughout the concert. September 2nd, 2020 marked the 75th commemoration of the end of World War II, a war that took the lives of over 405,000 U.S. military personnel. I do want to take this opportunity to thank the men and women in our audience who have served our country. Would you please stand or raise your hand? If you have any members who have served in World War II, would you please remain standing or raise your hand? We offer this performance today in gratitude to you and your service. Today's concert will feature a number of different ensembles from the EPO. You just heard a brass ensemble and percussion ensemble. We're also going to feature a brass quintet, string quintet, big band, and a number of special guests, including singers from the Evansville Philharmonic Chorus, the Legacy Dance Company, and Dr. James McLeod from the University of Evansville. Hymn to the Fallen from the film Saving Private Ryan is a memorial for all the soldiers who sacrificed themselves on the altar of freedom in the Normandy invasion on June 6, 1944. The great film director, Steven Spielberg, comments on Williams' film score. He said, "It's a piece of music and a testament to John Williams' sensitivity and brilliance that, in my opinion, will stand the test of time and honor forever the fallen of this war and possibly all wars. Saving Private Ryan possibly contains the least amount of score. Restraint was John Williams' primary objective. He did not want to sentimentalize or create emotion from what already existed in raw form. Saving Private Ryan is furious and relentless, as are all wars, but where is music? It is exactly where John Williams intends for us, the chance to grieve and remember." This arrangement you're going to hear today is going to be performed by our very own EPO Brass Quintet, and we're going to feature the singers from the Evansville Philharmonic Chorus who are positioned up in the balcony. They are led by their director, Andrea Drew. We hope you enjoy Hymn to the Fallen by John Williams. Thank you.
Andrew Higgins is the man who won the war for us. If Higgins had not designed and built those LCBPs, we never could have landed over an open beach. The whole strategy of the war would have been different. You'll notice right over there, we have an LCBP, a Higgins boat, positioned there, and that boat right there was actually used in the actual filming of the movie Saving Private Ryan. It was on set, which I think is really fantastic. So you see that right here in Evansville. We're now going to perform a version of Simple Gifts from Appalachian Spring. You may know the Copeland piece, Appalachian Spring, that's in LA. We're going to feature the I Can't String Quartet, our string quartet in residence of the Evansville Philharmonic Orchestra. We hope you enjoy this very moving and special arrangement. Enjoy.
Dr. James McLeod is a professor of history at the University of Evansville and one of the leading historians that has written about Evansville's involvement during World War II. James has been kind enough to share with all of us a fascinating set of photos which are in your program book. In the last few pages, it's in the digital program book and the program book in the hard copy program book. And it will show you just how involved Evansville was during the war. We were also grateful to receive a number of letters from the Wartime Museum from the Red Cross Canteen. Now this was opened between 1942 and 1946, right here in Evansville. And it was open 24/7. It was completely run by volunteers. So the Wartime Museum was very nice enough to give us a number of wartime letters. And I'd like James to read some of these letters so you could get a sense of Evansville's involvement during the war. Please welcome to the stage, Dr. James McLeod.
Thank you so much. So the first letter is from Company D, 1609th Service Unit, Fort Custer, Michigan, and it's addressed to the mayor of Evansville, Indiana. Honorable sir, my letter has a double purpose of complimenting you and the people of your city on the splendid Red Cross Canteen Railroad branch, which you are maintaining, and on the marvelous reception given to my troop convoy and me when we were on your city on Friday evening last week. I have traveled all over the country with troops, and although at every major stop there has been some attempt to provide for the soldiers, not one of the efforts measures up to the standards prevailing in Evansville. The quality and abundance of food, the feeling of genuine neighborliness, the sincere concern for the comfort of the soldiers made this experience an unforgettable one for the men of this convoy and me. I talked with members of the train crew and with the hostess of the canteen and learned that the entire city contributes supplies to the canteen, not with a feeling of compulsion, but because they want to do it. This spirit of cooperation was much in evidence at the canteen last Friday night. The hostess who had served us had worked more than two-thirds of a 24-hour period, and the men and women who met the train, the volunteer workers at the canteen, were bright-eyed, cheerful, and enthusiastic, insisting that no man leave without having taken some food. Certainly, you must realize, as I do, that this type of service is one of the best morale builders for members of the armed forces and for the civilian population as well. Very sincerely yours, W.F. Peterson, Captain. And then one more is from the office of the, and you can, by the way, see all of these letters reproduced inside the museum. They're up on the wall in the little section on the Red Cross canteen. While I was on convoy last week and passed through Evansville, I had the privilege of witnessing the work being done by your canteen and would like to express my appreciation and admiration of the great work of morale building that your organization is doing. I am certain that the 100-some soldiers and 3 carloads of sailors felt better both physically and mentally when the troop train pulled out of Evansville after sampling of the delicious food on hand at your canteen. The boys spoke of this incident throughout the trip. It is such organizations as yours that makes the trips made by troops so very much more enjoyable. It makes the boys feel as if they were home again. If there were more organizations of your kind throughout the country, it would be a great lift to the morale of the boys in the service of their country. It assures them that the civilian population is behind them 100%. And I am certain that the other troops which have had occasion to pass through your city join me in the praise of your canteen. Truly yours, James H. Ryan, Captain. Thank you. beautiful arrangement of Amazing Grace.
Their music gave a sense of familiarity for those who were abroad, both home front and war front. This song also provides a sense of patriotism. The three sisters performed at military posts, hospitals, radios, and rallies. The sisters performing in these places was a morale booster for the people and the country. What is surprising about this song is the fact that it is extremely upbeat for a wartime song. During this time, many of these pieces would have been slower, perhaps a little bit more lyrical and slow moving. We're happy to have our very own Andrew sisters here with us today. Please welcome Danice Henderson, Amber Ferguson, and Melissa Bethel, who are going to be performing and singing the role of the Boogie Boogie Bugle Boy. We also have the fantastic dancers with us from Legacy Dance Company, who are directed by Angela Paul. We hope you enjoy the Boogie Boogie Bugle Boy, featuring our very own EPO Big Band.
Oh,